when you don't remember to be the salt of the earth, and you begin to move and act on what you see, we begin to walk in being meraneo, which means being foolish. He said, and if it loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? Come on. He said, if it is then good for nothing but to be thrown out and to be trampled underfoot by man. So you got to understand that once salt loses its saltiness. See, if you put some salt in some water, come on here. You know when you have a toothache and they'll tell you, make some gargle your mouth with some salt and water. Come on here. See, if you put a lot of salt in a little water, you're going to taste that saltiness. Come on here. But when you begin to put a lot of water in it, and it water down the salt, it's not as potent as it would normally be. Come on here. Do you not know that that salt can't be back being potent no more? See, that's why God said you got to understand it's the enemy's job to get you when you're not potent. It's the enemy's job to get you when you don't understand who you are. That you just walk around like you just a natural man. Don't have no power. Don't have no authority. And you just walk around, can't nobody help me. Don't nobody understand me. And you, when we begin to believe that lie or what the devil has told us and not understand that that's a place where the enemy want to get the believer to, because he don't want you to shine. And Lord, he don't care about you going to church. He don't care about you giving money. He don't care about you reading your Bible. The problem that he got is when you begin to learn it and you begin to do what that Bible say, when you begin to walk in the power and authority, then he understand that you can shine. That's when he got a problem with you.
All right.
Because we begin to say, when I was in the world, I didn't have any problems.
Right.
You know why you didn't have any problems? Because you were not of God. Come on here. You were just a door. You didn't have no power. You would be praying and wouldn't nothing happen. Come on here. The devil was your friend. Because see, you got to understand, those who he got out there, they ain't got no problems. They may got a problem. But see, they don't understand. They feel like it's doomed. That's why when people go through, they blow their brains out. They feel like they can't make it. Because see, that the devil already got them. See, but we understand that when we are being the salt of the earth, see, we may be going through, but we got somebody we can go to. We got somebody who we can pray to. We got somebody who can deliver us. Because we understand that he said, Father, protect them because they are mine. Come on here. He said, can't nobody pluck them out of my hand. You got to understand the situation can't kill you. The situation can't destroy you. You got to understand God was bragging on you. That's why you in a situation. Because God said, I'm showing that. I know they're going through their marriage. How come they still smiling? How come they still going to church? Come on here. Girl, instead of you ain't got no money. Instead of you look like you're losing weight, you're gaining weight. How in the world? Come on here. Don't you understand? God said, I take the foolish things of this world to confine the wise. Come on here. Don't you understand? When you read the book of Daniel 10, come on here. He began to tell Daniel. Daniel began to tell him, you let them eat the things of the world, the things of the king's meat. He said, but I'm going to eat what my father told me to eat. You got to understand, I'm going to come out more sharper. I'm going to come out more happier. I'm going to come out more thinner. Because I'm doing what my God told me to do. See, some of you trying to do what the other folk doing in the world. God said, all you got to do is do what I tell you to do. I'm going to call you to shine. I'm going to call you to grow.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Because we trying to do what these folks doing in the world. Well, they doing this. They going to do it. They going to buy tickets. And they going to get people to come to the church. Ain't nothing wrong with giving people free stuff. But I understand that I even heard a man say, come on here. You don't just give them the fish, but you teach them how to fish. Come on here. I ain't going to come and pay your light bill. I ain't going to give you no gas. people and tell them we're going to give you this and we're going to give you that, because the devil, when you go to fight him, he ain't going to go easy on you. And then that's what's wrong with us in the church. We trying to do all kind of things to get people to come. See, if they don't come because they want Jesus, it ain't going to keep them. Because time you stop giving it to them, they're going to be out the door. But I understand when I give them Jesus, Jesus is the only thing that's going to keep them. Jesus is the only thing that's going to feed them. Jesus is the only thing going to teach them. And then God said, I'm trying to teach you how to shine. Not to do it man's way, but to do it my way. He said, because I'm the only one that will bring the increase. He said, look at verse 14. He said, you ought to be the light of the world. Come on. When I looked at that word light, light means force. It means a source of light that will radiate, that's radiant. In other words, it's bright. It illuminates in a place. It's a place where it denotes truth and its knowledge with spiritual purity. It's where nothing is hidden. See, God said, I want you to be in a place where you will radiate me. Amen. That when you open up your mouth, come on here, you begin to speak the truth to people, and they begin to hear things that they ain't never heard before. Wow. Don't you know that that's a light? Come on here. He said, I call you to be a light, to be the light of the world. See, you got to understand, when it's nighttime, what do you see in the sky? You see the stars in the sky. And what are they giving off? Light. He said, and that's what I call you to be in the world. I call you to be a light that no matter how much it gets dark in this world, that you will be a light to me. But let me explain this to you. When you are a light to him, in the world, it looks like you are a hater. Because the world calls God lightness, they call it hate. Because the world is owned by Satan, and the world don't want nobody to tell them what to do. The world don't want nobody to tell them how to live. The world don't want nobody to tell them, come on here, well, you want to try to go and make a baby in a tube, and God said, that ain't the way that I want to make a baby. I want